Dr. Komi Begedou, that is going to talk to us about the fifth anniversary of Grain de Sel. Dr. Kwame. Meanwhile, I was just calling you Dialogue Pasongi.
That's no problem. Because Dialogue also is a friend of mine.
He's so. A friend. So you didn't even bother that to correct me that.
I know that you will get the right information.
You're welcome in our studio today. Present yourself to the viewers. I know you are Dr. Komi Begedou, but you present yourself to the viewers.
Thank you very much. As you said, my name is Komi Begedou, and I am currently an assistant professor in the English department at the University of Lomé. And my area of specialization is American literature. But at the level of Grain de Sel Togo, I am the academic advisor. So that is why I am here, and I'm going to talk about Grain de Sel Togo.
Thank you. We're talking about Grain de Sel. There are some people that are watching us from their homes and wherever they are. They don't know what we talk. When we are talking about Grain de Sel, they don't know what is it. Can you please explain to us Grain de Sel before we move on?
Thank you very much. Grain de Sel is an international non-profit organization that started in 2013 in the U.S., especially in the state of Georgia. And the idea came in with just an observation. So five grantees who benefited from the Fulbright. Fulbright is actually grant that the Department of State offers to, you know, brilliant students to go to the U.S. and to further their studies. So there were five Togolese who also were grantees of this Fulbright scholarship. So when they got the sponsorship or the scholarship from Fulbright Commission, they said, okay, in fact, we are learning from this, and we can try to do something also to help our young brothers and sisters back home. So they initiated this, and they said, we are going to try something. So they put themselves together, and they started putting together some dollars, and you know, with that they started the idea or the organization to support people here back here in the university, public universities in Togo. So so far we are, God is helping us, and we are moving, and we are helping the people back here in Togo.
Thank you so much, Dr. Komi Begedou. We know GDS is Grain de Sel. So now, why Grain de Sel?
Grain de Sel, because in French is Grain de Sel, and Grain de Sel is the grain of salt. So it means we believe that even if you don't have much, with your small grain of salt, when you bring it, and the other person brings his own, then we can have a good soup that will be, you know, a good, will have a good taste. So we believe that even if you don't have much, but you have a good will, you can come with the small resource that you have, and we'll put it together to help the other people. So that is why the idea have come, because there are many students who are willing to go forward, to go further in their studies, but because they're limited in their financial means, you know, material means, and all the rest. So we think that having this kind of organization is a very good thing, so that we will help the younger brothers and sisters who are willing to go further but have limited resources. So that is why we have started the organization.
We know you are at your fifth anniversary.
Yeah.
What are the activities all around this celebration?
Thank you very much. As we are, you know, having this celebration here, because here in Togo we have a national representation in Togo, but back in the U.S. also they are having some activities just to let know what Grain de Sel is doing, and also to ask for people who are willing to support this organization to continue its activities. So far we have done a lot of things within the 5 years. We have been able to, you know, have 25 grantees all over the country here in Togo, and also in Burkina Faso, and actually one person in France. So as I said it before, we support people from the public universities. So Togo has two public universities, one in Lomé here and one in Kara. So far we have helped students get grants from the University of Lomé and the University of Kara. Apart from that, we have also organized, so when I'm talking about the grant, is not only the financial support, we also have a coaching session for them. We have also online learning for them, and also we boost their, you know, capacity of creating and managing their own companies. And apart from that, we have two great you know, major training sessions at the University of Lomé, one in 2014 and the other one in 2015, where we talk about the possibility for these young people to know that they can create and they can succeed in their lives. And apart from that, we also have some, you know, campaigns of sanitization in various cities of the country where we help the people in these localities understand that they need to have their, you know, legal documents so that they will not have problems in their future. So as you asked me the question, you said, what are we trying to do for this celebration? We are currently preparing a training session because we have felt the need to train our grantees, not only the grantees, but also students in general, on how to manage their time, because we have noticed that many people nowadays don't know how to manage their time. So they are complaining that they don't have time just because they don't know how to plan their activities. Yeah. And worse is the misuse of the social networks. So the social network are there. They are time consuming things. So we need people to tell them that this is the right way for you to, you know, use the thing and to prepare yourself. So that is what we're going to do and we are planning to do.
These are the things you're doing around your celebration.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. I'll be back with you. There is an interview that we're going to listen to. Run and watch it and then I'll come back with you.
Thank you very much.
Grain de Sel is a student association on the university campuses of Lomé and Kara. It works for the well-being of best but poor students among the poor. Let's listen to Mr. Nyazo Yao, a beneficiary of Grain de Sel grant, recorded by Patrick. Let's watch it.
Friend who told me about Grain de Sel Togo, and that year, it was last year, so I was not, the document required was not this thing for me, so I wait for this year, and because of there are a lot of criteria that I have to meet, and I wait this year. As I pass all my subjects, I apply for it, and thank God, they say they need hardworking students, and I think I'm one. And students who are needy, and I think I'm also one. And thank God, I'm selected to do the interview, and I'm selected to be granted. One of the criteria of Grain de Sel is to work on a community development project, and currently, I'm working on one. And I think the best way to help other students is to engage myself in Grain de Sel work and also contribute to the development of the organization, and in order to be expanded to other high school or other countries in Africa. First of all, I will say before the grant, I was struggling to get money for my studies because I was thinking that, okay, this year, I did not think that I can continue this year. I was thinking that this year, maybe I will not continue. I will drop out because of financial problem. And after the grant, the money that they used to give me helped me in order to buy my books and transportation, which make that I pass the subject for this semester. And the semester I'm in now, I'm praying God to help me pass all the subjects with good grade. I will tell the other students that are in need, like me, that are hardworking, that Grain de Sel grant is not a myth, it is a reality.
Dr. Kobe Begedou, this is one of your grantees.
Yes.
Time is not on our side, so I'm going to ask you the last question and you give us the conclusion. We know there is a coming training.
Yeah.
Can you please talk to us about the training? Why this training, and why are you having this training? What is it about, and when is it coming on? And then give us a conclusion because time is not on our side.
Yeah, thank you very much. So as you said it, so he's one of our grantees, and this year, or you know, one of the criteria is that our grantees should have a community project, so they need to go. Because they have received something, they need to give back.
Yeah.
So we are helping them to build up their project that they are going to implement in their various localities. So the training you talk about actually was supposed to take place next Saturday, but it has been postponed because of some technical problems. So but it will come, it will take place surely in the coming month.
Okay.
And it's about time management and the good use of social network. So the objective of this training is, as I said it before, to help the young students at the universities or in the universities of Togo to understand that it is true that we have 24 hours a day, but if you don't pay attention, these 24 hours will pass and you will not do anything. So we need to tell them how to pray. So we have some people who are gifted and talented and experienced in these areas. So they are the ones coming. So we are just telling people who are watching us that the training will come very soon and they will get the detailed information in the coming future. So they need to get ready and to come there because it is going to be a very good opportunity for them to know how to manage well their time and also how to make good use of the social network. Because the social network have the good side and also the bad side. So okay. They need people to help them to be balanced, to know the balanced way of using this social
network. All right. Dr. Akobi Begedou, it's unfortunate that we don't have much time. But thank you so much for honoring our invitation. Do you have the last word some few seconds and then we...
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much for this privilege. Mm-hmm. And talking about the last work, I want to thank the CEO of this organization, Mr. Brad Nkoti, because he's, you know, somebody who has the youth, the success of the youth in his heart, and he wants to support them. And I want to thank also all the donors for this organization. And also, my last work is to ask other people who really want to help the young people move forward to come and support us so that we will do this work. And
thank
also
so
I have a
much.
Message for the students that they need to work hard because success is not given to people who don't work hard. So they need to work hard and God will help them.
Now that's your whole last word. Thank you so much for your invitation. Beautiful viewers, we are back with the news. The fourth Catholic charismatic